is really important, the whole history of the flood here.
Yep.
Yeah. So what was your first
thing? Well, they were trying to let some water out of the upper reservoir. But that's not the whole cause of flood. You know, the whole thing. You see this? That watershed goes all the way to Hunter and Windham.
Yeah.
And that flood control dam in Maple Crest broke. Mm-hmm. Well, that came down into Prattsville, and then it all came right on down. You know.
Yeah.
And they were trying to let water out at the power authority.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they couldn't control the gate. Went right on up, full open.
Why couldn't they control the gate?
They said they were running on electricity. They didn't have electricity.
Wow.
No.
So what? So you actually saw the water come down?
Well, I actually saw the water come right across those flats there in front of my house. I was standing on my porch.
Wow. How high was it?
Like a big wall. I'd say 6 foot high. A lot of water.
Wow.
You know, the first thing I saw was water, a small stream started to come over. And it just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And the first thing you know, it come right up over that riverbank. And you know that river down there is weird. It flows north.
What?
The beaver
come from Hunter and Windham, and then they meet at Prattsville, and then they go up to the reservoir, and then it flows up to...
It goes to the Mohawk.
Rotterdam. Yeah, and joins the Mohawk.
That's right.
Except where the Gilboa Dam is, there's a tunnel that takes... The draws for the city water supply go through the tunnel, and they come out on Shandaken into the Esopus. And the Esopus has a lot of flooding, like regular spring flooding every year. But you know, big events like this—that's why. That's probably why Phoenicia got hammered. Is the city is probably trying to draw down the Schoharie Dam, and then right next to the Schoharie Dam is the pump storage, the Blenheim Gilboa, and that was the other dam where the gate failed, where they lost power to control the gate.
So, what did it look like? You said you saw houses. And...
Yeah, houses going by.
Trees.
Wow.
Trailers. Oh, it was awful. And then there was trailers there right below my house caught fire because the water picked them right up and put them right up in the treetops there.
Yeah.
You know, if anybody went down that valley, that was a sight. There was pumpkins hanging from the power lines. That's how deep it got down there.
But the story, I mean, so it's actually not, everybody saying, oh, it was just it was too much water, but it was actually a lot of the manipulations in the dams that caused it.
Yeah, well, there was too much water and manipulations. I think it both together was too much.
Yeah. So ordinarily they would have what opened up the gate a little bit, or
yeah, try to let it down a little. But then, see, they were working on the Gilboa Dam, and I understand, you know, that it broke through on the edge of that dam and went around too.
Yeah,
on the Gilboa Dam, it was a combination. That's all it was.
So,
and then that big dam in Maple Crest, that's a big flood control dam. That let go.
Where's that?
Well, above Windham.
It's right up on the escarpment.
Wow.
So how long was the gate open for?
That I don't know. I don't know.
Because once it's open, they couldn't exactly close it.
No, they couldn't. Because they didn't have no electricity to operate. That's what happened.
Wow. So how about your land? Were you okay? Are you high up there?
Well, I got it real bad the second day. Come down from up above the other way, flooded my barn, ruined my hay in the bottom.
Oh, my God.
They're going to
But you didn't lose the barn.
Nope.
Wow.
But I got it anchored good because I'd built a shed on the back. I set no home poles, you know, but I had a good hole.
What's the alternative?